Please welcome János here on the stage.
Hello, everybody. Okay. Today I will talk to you about a new development framework called SDRflow, and I will show you how you could use this framework to develop data processing applications for use some SDR purposes. I will present you a demo, a very simple data processing applications, and I show you how you could implement these applications using the framework. And at the end of the presentation, I will show you how you could run these applications and really how it's work. Now, you, I talk very shortly what is this framework. Okay, it's a development framework, and it is based on the data flow model. It uses the synchronous data flow model, and in this respect, it is different from other data flow frameworks like GNU Radio or Photos SDR, or there is a very large data flow framework in the United States called Torben. It is used in the universities. this framework is component based. Okay. In the framework, we have two types of components. The primitive components, which you have to write in C language, and you should compile it with the GNU C compiler into shared library. And you have the composite components. You write those composite components with the framework, a special new language, and compile it with the compiler, which came with the framework. This compiles a binary code, and this binary code could be executed by the framework's runtime applications. The framework is pretty lightweight. It is entirely written in C language, and has very few system dependencies. It uses the standard C libraries and some mathematical libraries, nothing else. The framework is open sourced, licensed under GPL3 or any later version. It is published on the GitHub. You could download it and start to play with it. Currently, the framework works on 64-bit Linux systems. I have tested it on Ubuntu 16.04. One of my friends tested on the newest Ubuntu 18.04. But it should work in almost any 64-bit Linux system. Okay, this slide show you actually the development process. If you don't like the runtime, or you have some special requirement for the runtime, you have the source code of the runtime. You have you could make modification and compile it. After that, you have to decompose your applications into primitive and composite components. You have to write the primitive components in C. Write the composite components with the SDRflow language, compile all the components, and after that, the runtime system could execute your applications. Right now, the runtime system has a very rudimentary help for you to debug your applications. It's a command line interface. In the next iteration of the system, you will have some graphical instrumentation like oscilloscope, spectrum analyzer. Actually, you could work on the system like you work on the laboratory with the old analog systems. Okay, let's see the demo applications. It's a very simple. It's a CW transmitter connected to the CW receiver through a channel. It's working in the minus 24 to plus 24 kilohertz frequency range. It uses 48 kilosampere per second sample rate. The transmitter will transmit repeatedly a given text. The channel will add to this transmission an interfering CW signals. The receiver filters a small band from the spectrum, demodulate the CW signals, which is in this small band, and put it the demodulated signals to the sound card. Okay, this is the top level of the demo applications. Okay, in this figure and the following figures, the big rectangles mean the components. If it's a rounded rectangles, it means that it's a primitive components, and this normal rectangles is composite components. Okay, this the small squares with the letters in it means the internal signals of the system. With the letter S is the stream-like signals. This is really the sample stream. Okay, you have to process it. And in the rectangles with C or occasionally with V are parameters which are constants or variables. Okay, the CW transmitter is very simple. It has a CW generator which generate the baseband CW signal. And followed by a mixer, which actually not a mixer, but it's a frequency shifter, which shifts the baseband to the transmitting frequency. Okay, the mixer, okay, consists of two parts, a signal generator, which generates a complex exponential signal, and a multiplier, which multiply the carrier with the input signals and put it the output to the output of the composite. Okay, the channel demonstrate how you could reuse some components. Okay, we use the CW transmitter to generate the interfering signals and use an adder which add the interfering signals to the CW transmissions. Okay, the receiver, it's much more complicated. Okay, it starts with a mixer or frequency shifter. This shifts the receiving frequency to the baseband. After it, we have a filter, which is really a low-pass filter, and the filter output will be shifted to the beat frequency. And this upshifted signal we will put into the sound card. Okay, let's see the filter. The filter has two parts. The first part generates the frequency response of the filter, and the other part is implement the overlap and save method of filtering. Today, more than one presentation talk about this method. Okay, the frequency response generator first generate the impulse response of the filter and generate a Windows function, multiply these two streams, and the result of the multiplication will be Fourier transform. And the Fourier transform, output of the Fourier transformation is the frequency response of the filter. Okay, the overlap and save method begins with the overlap primitives. This overlap concatenate together two block of samples. After it, this large block will be Fourier transformed, multiplied by a frequency response, inverse Fourier transform, and half of the result of the inverse Fourier transform will be thrown away. Now, how to how to write a primitive components? Okay, the framework will help you to generate the necessary files for these primitive components. You need three files. The one file for an interface declaration. This interface declaration will be used by the framework's special compiler. It shows this special compiler how to handle these primitives. The other is a C language header file, which in which you have to define the necessary structures which you need to interface the primitive components to the runtime. And you have the C language file, which contains five functions. The primitive could have five functions. Okay, framework make system will generate these files for you. Okay? After it, the framework generated these files, you have to fill in the interface declaration. After it, fill in the context structure in the header files and write these five functions. After that, with the build system, you could compile it. Your primitives. You don't have to write make files or anything else. Everything the build system will automatically pick up if he will see a new primitives in the system. Okay, here you need the interface declaration file. Okay, which is in green, is generated by the system, and which is in red that you have to fill in. Okay. Actually, you have to fill the ports of your components. Okay. This is a very simple primitive which has an input ports and output ports. It takes from the input ports a float number and negate it, and the result will be put into the output port. Okay, that it has to have one input port and one output port. Okay, here is the C header files. Okay. For this component, okay, you have to fill the context structure. In this context structure, there should be a pointer for each port which you declared in the interface declaration file. And the entry in the two files have to be in the same order. That's very important. And the type of the pointers should be the same type what you use in the interface declaration. Okay, there are a self structure if you need to save some data from one run of the components to the next run. In that case, you could put it into the self structure. For the simple components, we don't need it. Okay, you have five functions for the primitives. Okay, the load function is executed just after the shared library is loaded into the memory. In this function, you could do component level. Initializations or reserve component level resources. The init function is executed whenever an instance of the component is created. in this function, you could make instance level initialization or reserve instance level resources. Okay, the workhorse horse function is the fire function. This should contain the algorithm of your components. Okay, the cleanup function is invoked whenever an instance will be deleted, before the instance will be deleted. Here you should free all the instance level resources. The same thing for the delete function is called just before the shared library is deleted from the memory. Here you should free all the component level resources. Okay, this is only for demonstration. This structure tells the framework how to handle these primitive components. Actually, it has the list of the function pointers which will be called by the framework. Okay, that's how you make a composite components. Here, once again, the build system will help you to create the necessary files for the composite. After that, you have to declare which subcomponents you like to use it. After that, like in the primitive cases, you have to declare the interface declaration of your components. It's very similar what you have to do in the primitive components. After that, you have to declare all the internal signals in your components. You declare all the instances what you like to use inside the components. Declare the topology, which means how the instances are connected by the signals. And finally, you have to give some hints for the compiler how to what type of scheduling you like to have. And once again, the make system will compile your composite. Okay, here is the mixer composite. Okay, in the mixer you use two components, the signal generator and the multiplier. Okay, the mixer has an input, an output, and two parameter input. Okay, right now the mixer uses complex signals, and right now I implemented in such a way that the complex signal consists of a real stream and an imaginary stream. Okay? The mixer has a single internal signals, okay, which is the carrier. Okay, here is the two instances of the components. The Rocard oscillator is an instance of the signal generator, and the mult is an instance of the multiplier. Okay, here you could see the topology, which corresponds to the block diagram what I showed you. Okay, how to get started? Okay, you need to have or recommend to have an Ubuntu 64-bit operating system. You should install some prerequisites, install Git, make, GCC, and two development versions of two libraries. Okay, that's only for the demo purposes. I used the Pulse Audio, and I could use the LibFFTW3. After it, you should create a working directory if you don't have one. In the working directory, you should clone the repository from GitHub, go to the SDRFlow directory, and with the make all command, you could build the whole system. Okay. If the make all is successful, in that case you could start these demo applications in the bin directory. There is the runtime executable, the SDF run. After it you executed, it will prompt you an SDRflow prompt. And for this prompt, you can issue several commands. Okay, the whole command set is documented in the GitHub. With the load command, you could load the demo application and the instance called demo. Actually, you could run several instances of this application parallel. With the start command, you could start the demo applications. You could try some other commands with which you could change the configuration parameters. When you start these demo applications, you will hear the CV transmissions. Okay, with the kill command, you could stop the demo application and you could exit from the runtime with the exit command. Now, what's the future plan? Okay, I will provide support for 32-bit Linux systems. It's very important because some ARM processors, which is built into together with FPGAs, could run only 32-bit systems. Okay, I like to provide support for some ARM processors without operating system. I will do this graphical instrumentations, and I have plans to add some extension to the data flow, which is very helpful to build more complex applications. Okay, how you could switch to this?
To where?
This demo.
Just prints here.
Okay. Oh, it's not showing.
Not showing. Okay, just a moment.
We have to start it once again. Yeah,
doesn't matter. We have to just shift it over to the other screen.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, play.
Yeah. Right now we load the application, demo application, we started. Change the frequency. That's the interfering signal. Once again, change the receiving frequency, just the middle of the two signals. You hear nothing because I have a 200 hertz filter. Now I start to increase the filter bandwidth. Now it's a 800 hertz. You hear both signals. And right now I start to decrease the bandwidth. Still a little bit coming out. again change the receiving frequency to the original one. I tried to change the text. Components from the memory and exit from the program. Okay. Any questions?
So you said that was as a Kronos framework?
No, that's my
my
own framework.
Yeah, so how...
The synchronous hierarchical synchronous data flow framework.
So how does that work? So how does the schedule...
Actually, the major thing is that every actors, okay, uses the same amount of data in every run.
Okay.
That's the major thing, okay? And everything is followed from that. Because in that case, you could pre-compute the schedule. The schedule in most of the cases is periodic. Okay? And it means that there is an upper bound on the signal storage requirement. And one more thing, you could use explicit feedback loops.
Yeah, that's nice.
Okay? For that, there is sometimes you need a trick. You could put some delays into the feedback loops. Delays means that there are some amount of data originally in the buffer, okay? But you could schedule it.
Yeah.
This is the and it's very lightweight. This executable, it's 200 key.
Nice.
And it's doing dynamic loading, okay? But there is a possibility that I put the primitive components code into the runtime. In that case, you don't need the dynamic load mechanism. That much more simple the
makes sense executable. In the OS3 sense, yeah.
And actually, I tried this executable. Okay, with a special version, even I could run it in an ARM Cortex M4.
Thank you.
Any more questions? No more questions?